Hello and welcome to today's Daily Market Update with me, Josh Mahoney, Research Analyst here at Alpari UK. Seeing a little bit of upside in the indices throughout Europe and over in the US. Now, some of this is in line with the fact that we've actually seen a bit of a positive start to earnings season with the likes of Alcoa kicking it off. And that is really going to be feeding into the markets and really dictating play. Last week, we saw some real major economic announcements in the form, especially of the non-farm payrolls and alike on Friday, along with some big data out of the UK. And really, today is actually very quiet on the data front. Tomorrow, being Thursday, is actually going to be the real mainstay of the whole week in terms of major events. Whereas today, the real event of note so far really came overnight from the Chinese region when we saw their CPI figure actually pull back to 2.3. This came back from the 2.5 level. We did expect to see some sort of pullback. We thought it was going to come in around about 2.4. So in actual fact, the fact that we've seen this at 2.3 means that they're really in a sweet spot over in China at the moment, bearing in mind that they have actually been actively using measured stimulus steps over in the Chinese region to actually prop up the economy. We've seen recently a slowdown that we're just coming out of the back of it now, and we saw the same kind of thing around about a year ago. And at each step, they use the likes of monetary policy and fiscal policy and with stimulus to just inject into the economy and push it forward. Now, if we saw rampant inflation at 3% plus, probably a bit higher, I think they're willing to even tolerate 3% over in China. If we saw it above 3%, then they'd potentially want to ease off on that kind of thing. But where we see it pull back towards that 2% target, that's when, you know, people within the markets realize that they can essentially continue with their stimulus measures if and when they actually need it. So it is very good for the Chinese economy and it is very buoyant for the region going forward. Now, in terms of the rest of the day, there hasn't been too much and really everyone's waiting off for the FOMC meeting minutes, which are going to be released tonight. And essentially, we're looking for the same kind of thing. You know, in terms of the pathway for the end of asset purchases, it seems very set and determined to me. I expect that to be finishing by the end of the year. But now everyone's looking forward to when we're going to see interest rates hike. In the UK, it's quite likely that we're actually going to see the first interest rate hike, and we think we're going to see a interest rate hike in the US region a little bit later, so more likely 2015, but there's a potential for 2014 in the UK. However, you know, we're looking for some sort of note from this. You know, how is Janet Yellen voting towards this? Are we hearing from some of the other members that they're potentially swaying towards even thinking about voting for an interest rate hike? So that's what we're looking for. Now, I don't necessarily expect to see exactly this because this meeting happened soon after we actually saw the release of non-farm payrolls and unemployment figures last month. And do remember that despite the massive revision that we've seen earlier this month to the previous figure, the figure that they had to go on at the time of this meeting was actually pretty poor and at the lower end of the 200s, whereas in actual fact they've revised that a lot higher and we've got seen a very positive figure this time around. So at the next meeting we're a lot more likely to see them pushing towards the tone of, you know, when are we going to see an interest rate hike. But I think for the moment they're probably going to be pressing on with being accommodative going forward, especially with some of the different things that are happening around the world in terms of like conflict in Ukraine and Iraq and alike. I think there is more emphasis on being accommodative going forward. But do look out for this. It's a real major event and it can bring significant volatility to the markets. Now, as I was saying previously, tomorrow is the main event of the week, only for the fact that we've got three pretty major events happening and therefore we've got the potential for some pretty significant volatility. So overnight we have the jobs report out of Australia. Bear in mind that Australia's actually been doing quite well despite a slowdown in China. So we're really looking to see whether they can push on as we see the strength coming back into China. Also, we have the monthly bulletin out of the Eurozone. So there we're going to look and see exactly how the Eurozone is faring and how they think growth is going to be dictated going forward and how we think that the ECB's actions are going to be influencing the rate of inflation going forward. And then finally, we have the Bank of England monetary policy decision, which I don't necessarily think we're going to see very much at all. But again, it's another real major event to be looking out for. So that's it for today, guys. If you want any more news analysis, come and check out the Alpari newsroom at alpari.co.uk/newsroom, or check me out on Twitter. My name's Josh Mahoney, research analyst here at Alpari UK. Have a great day.